80-year-old Alice Ryan lived in Greenville, South Carolina in 1988. She was known as a wealthy socialite, a widow, and a great-aunt of Greenville Mayor Knox White. On October 8, 1988, Alice left her home for chemotherapy. She had been diagnosed with lung cancer a few months earlier. Later in the day, she made her way back to her home. Alice's daughter decided to visit her that day, and when she arrived at Alice's home, she found her mother's car gone and a back door was ajar. Inside, she found Alice's body. She had been stabbed numerous times. Her car and a few other items had been stolen. It was a crime that infuriated the community. Investigators were really intent on trying to find the attacker right away. Every lead they had ended up in a dead end, however, and the case went cold for many decades. Recently, investigators reopened the case. They found DNA evidence belonging to an African-American man on one of the items that was collected and stored from the crime scene. It was submitted to the Combined DNA Index System, also known as CODIS. In November 2017, investigators were notified of a CODIS hit to a matching DNA profile. The DNA profile belonged to a 50-year-old man living in Americus, Georgia. After some more investigating and DNA testing, Brian Keith Munns was arrested. The motive for the crime seems to be burglary. It was not classified as a hate crime. Greenville Police Chief Ken Miller had this to say, "It validates that we should never give up on a case. We should never give up hope. We should never give up our efforts to try and bring justice to those that were harmed and closure for their families." Tanya Van Kellenborg was born on March 7, 1969 in British Columbia, Canada. In 1987, 18-year-old Tanya met 20-year-old J. Roland Cook, who was also from British Columbia. The two of them started dating. By November, the two of them had been in a relationship for about 6 months. On 18 November, Jay and Tanya left in his father's bronze 1977 Ford Club van. They left for an overnight trip to Seattle, Washington. Their plan was to buy parts for Jay's father's business. It was their first trip together, and they planned a romantic weekend. They took a 4 p.m. car ferry to Port Angeles, Washington. After disembarking from the ferry, they drove south into Hoodsport around 8 p.m. After that, they drove past Allen, most likely on their way to Bremerton, Washington. It is believed that they then boarded another car ferry that went from Bremerton to downtown Seattle. Jay and Tanya were supposed to make it back home on November 19, but they did not. On November 20, they were reported missing. 4 days later, on November 24, Tanya's body was found on the side of a road near Elgar in Skagit County, Washington. She had been assaulted, bound with plastic ties, and shot. Jay was nowhere to be seen, so investigators believed that he could be responsible for what happened to Tanya. The day after Tanya was found, on November 25th, her wallet and keys were found discarded near the Greyhound station in Bellingham, Washington. A few blocks away, the van was found. Inside were plastic ties of the same type used to bind Tanya, plastic gloves, and Bremerton, Seattle tickets. Tanya's camera was missing and has never been recovered. On November 26, Jay's body was found nearly 60 miles away from where Tanya's body had been found 2 days earlier. He had been beaten with rocks and strangled. After some more investigating, DNA could be collected from an unknown man inside a van. Investigators were unable to find a match in any of the criminal databases. It was also believed that the attacker was familiar with the prison system. The lack of a match, despite a potential prison background, could be explained by the suspect having been incarcerated before DNA collection from criminals became commonplace or technologically possible. Jay and Tanya's family members received a series of greeting cards written by someone who claimed to be the attacker. The cards had postmarks from Seattle, Los Angeles, and New York. it was all written by the same person. In 2010, investigators announced that a rider of the cards had been found. He was a 78-year-old Canadian transient who had mental health issues. It was confirmed that he had no connection to the crimes. On April 11, 2018, investigators asked Parabon Nanolabs if they could help solve the case. They were able to create a composite sketch of the attacker using his DNA that was found on Tanya's body and inside a van. Parabon also made use of genetic genealogy. They submitted the DNA of the suspect to the public website jetmatch.com. They were able to create a family tree of the suspect. This led investigators to 55-year-old William Tabbitt. He worked as a truck driver. Investigators followed him around and found a paper cup that he had used. DNA was taken from it and matched the DNA found on Tanya's body. On May 18, 2018, the Snohomish County Sheriff announced that William had been arrested. His parents lived just 7 miles away from where Jay's body was found. In June 2019, William was found guilty of taking the lives of Tanya and Jay. He was given 2 sentences of life in prison and is currently serving in a Washington State Penitentiary. Tracy Lynn Hammerberg was born on March 7, 1966 in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. During her childhood, her family moved to Saukville, Wisconsin. She attended Port Washington High School. On December 15, 1984, 18-year-old Tracy was babysitting at a house in Saukville. Thereafter, she walked to a grocery store to meet her friends. Tracy and her friends then drove to Quaid's Tavern in Port Washington. Then she and her friends went to a party in Grafton, Wisconsin. They played a beer drinking game and smoked weed. After midnight, Tracy left to walk home. The walk was about 4 miles. Tracy never made it home. Her body was found dumped on a snowy driveway on Maple Road in Grafton. She had head injuries and had been assaulted. More than 400 men were eliminated as suspects using DNA testing. In March of 2019, investigators made use of genetic genealogy to help solve the case. They were able to create a DNA profile from skin that was found under Tracy's fingernails that belonged to an unknown man. The Los Angeles Federal Bureau of Investigation also helped out. Finally, in August 2019, they were able to confirm that Philip Cross took Tracy's life. Philip was a Wisconsin man who passed away in 2012. He was 21 years old at the time of the crime. Those who knew Philip said that he was abusive and aggressive towards others.